So, there might be form elements that are visible to a user, but not connected to any attribute and therefore to any data in the database. They may have an empty DataPath property, or don't have it at all. There also might exist form attributes that are not connected to any form element and therefore invisible to a user. But more often than not, we use connected element-attribute pairs when we want a user to see and edit some database data. This is what we use a filled form element for. The most natural way of establishing the connection between an attribute and an element looks like this. I'm just dragging the attribute I want to show on the form and dropping it to the elements list. What the platform did here is it automatically added a new element of the filled type. Why filled? Because this is how we display and edit a single attribute value in one's enterprise. We use fields. Every single element in this list is a field, as you can see. At the same time, all these fields look and work quite differently. The description is a string field I can type in like this. The product type is a drop-down list with enumeration values. And these three fields down here show drop-downs with recently used values, allow adding a new value at the spot, or open the catalog choice form like this. How come the same element behaves that differently for different attributes? Well, there are some settings as always, same old, same old. First of all, the filled element cannot live without the data path property being set. I mean, I can add a filled element with an empty data path, but it will have no idea what it's doing here and won't even show up on the form. As soon as the filled element is connected to some attribute, it jumps on board and displays itself on the form. It also starts offering a bunch of functionality and appearance options, depending on the data type of the attribute it's connected to. First of all, there are types. Each of these is carefully honed for a very specific type of attribute data. So when you drop an attribute to the element list, the platform gives it the best fit for the job type. But if you want to fill out the description using radio buttons for whatever reason, the platform won't try to stop you. A form element connected to a reference type attribute cannot be typed in by a user manually. Its value needs to be chosen from a list, like this product type attribute, for example, which can accept only product type's enumeration values. Therefore, this kind of element has only these three options. There are only two values in this enumeration, so it's perfectly logical to use radio buttons. Radio button field type requires a fixed list of values to choose from, so I'm going to the choice list setting and clicking fill. Looks like I can add any number of other values to the list, but this is not the case. I can use only values the enumeration contains. I can delete some values though, if I don't need all of them in here. I can also select between these two appearances, and this is how the tumbler looks like. As for the catalog ref type attributes, like these three guys here, their values cannot be selected from the fixed list, so the elements representing them on the form feature a different kind of a dropdown. It shows the recently chosen values, allows me to add a new catalog item on the fly, open the selected item and edit it, or open the full catalog items list in a separate window like this. So choosing the correct filled element type and setting up its main properties, which can be delegated to the platform, covers all typical needs when it comes to displaying and editing attributes. But of course we can set up the filled element in almost any way imaginable if we so desire. For example, this is our service buttons arsenal. Let me show you some of them. This is a drop-down list button we've seen already. This is the choice list button we usually use to open the full list of values to choose from. We also have the clear button to delete the current value, the spin button to increase or decrease a numerical field value, the open button to open the item currently selected, and so on. After we added these buttons, we can handle their events and customize their behavior in any way we like. This is how we use the field element.